If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in unto him. I will sup with him. I will fellowship with him. You come to the Lord. You say, today I open the door of my heart. Come in today. Come in to stay. Come in and forgive me. Come in and cleanse me. Come in and take my sins away. Humble yourself before the Lord. Open the door of your heart to the Lord. Leave the old life and cleave to the new life. For this shall a man leave father and mother and cleave unto his wife. He wants to be your bridegroom. He wants to be your husband. He wants to be your healer. He wants to be your Lord and master. You leave the old master and you cleave unto the Lord. You leave sin and you cleave to the Savior. You leave darkness and cleave to the light. You leave evil and cleave to his grace. Incline your ears unto the Lord. He says he wants to bring you the sure mercies of David. He wants to give you the mercy of forgiveness, the mercy of reconciliation with God, the mercy of a new life in Christ. And then he says, incline your ears unto me. That's what he tells us in Isaiah chapter 55 and verse 3. Incline your ears. You've been listening to Satan. You've been listening to wrong voices. Now the Lord has come. He says, prepare. Prepare the way for the Lord to come. And incline your ears. And pay attention to what he's saying. Humble yourself before the Lord. Open the door before him. Leave the past and cleave to the new life. And incline your ears, incline your heart unto the Lord. And now bring all your sins together. And nail that sin to the cross of Calvary. All your body, all your sorrow, all your heartache, all your iniquity, all your evil, all your wickedness. It says, bring everything, that's Colossians chapter 2, and nail it to the cross. He wants you to deliberately do that, so that all those sins are forgiven, all those sins are taken away, all those sins are now nailed to the cross of Calvary. You're not holding them anymore. You're not embracing them anymore. You're not performing them anymore. You're not practicing them anymore. You're not enjoying them anymore. You bundled all the sins together. And you look at the cross of Calvary. And then you say, Lord, I nail all my sins to the cross of Calvary. In Colossians chapter 2, verse 14, blotting out the and writing of ordinances that was against us, which was contrary to us, and he took it out of the way, nailing it to his cross, and having spoiled principalities and powers, he made a show of them openly, triumphing over them in it. Then escape for your life. Destruction is coming upon Sodom. Destruction is coming upon Egypt. Destruction is coming upon Babylon. And he has sent his angels to you. He doesn't want you to perish. He's sending his messengers to you. He does not want you to perish. And he says in Genesis chapter 19 verse 17, escape for your life. Don't stay in all the place. Don't linger in sin. Don't relax in sin. Don't see it in sin. Don't abide in sin. Escape. Come out and let the Lord see that you have come out. He says, seek the Lord while it may be found. Seek the Lord while it may be found. Call ye upon him. Call upon his name. You'll be my Savior. You'll be my Lord. You'll be my Redeemer. And then he says, all the iniquity in your hand, let the wicked forsake his way. And your righteous man his thoughts. And let him call upon the Lord. And let him return from all his ways. And God says, I will hear. And I will pardon. And then you surrender your life completely to the Lord. My son, give me your heart. And let your eyes delight in my way. That's the preparation is asking of you.
That
you say, I want that new creation. I want the touch of the Lord in my life. I want the transformation in my life. And he says, humble yourself. Come down. From that ivory tower of pride. Come down with that, from that self-conceit. Come down from that evil place that belongs to Satan. Humble yourself before the Lord. Open the door of your heart to the Lord. Leave your sins and cleave to the Savior. Incline your heart and your ears to the Lord. Nail all your sins to the cross of Calvary. Escape for your life. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call you upon him while his name. Let the wicked forsake his way. And your righteous man is thoughts. And let him return unto the Lord. And the Lord will abundantly pardon. And then surrender completely to the Lord. Jesus, you surrender yourself on Calvary for me. And I come now, I surrender myself unto you. They will forgive you. Yaba, answer. He will forgive you. He will set you free. He will heal your body. He will turn your life around. He will get you out of that dungeon where the devil has put you. He will lift you up today. I come to point number 3. I'm talking to somebody now. I said I'm talking to somebody now. Where are you there? Are you hearing? Are you going to answer the Lord? When he calls me, I will answer. He wants to lift me up. He wants to forgive me. He wants to set me free. When he calls me, I will answer. Who will answer over there? I said, who will answer over there? Lord, call your people. Call them out of that prison. Bring them to the palace. Call them out of that dungeon. Bring them to dominion. I know you will answer. Something good will happen to you. Your portion in the new, in its new holiness. Look at this. Isaiah chapter 43. Isaiah chapter 43. I'm reading from verse 18. He did the old creation. He made the whole creation. But Adam and Eve fell. And we fell in them and with them. But now he says, I'm going to do it all over again. He will do it all over again in your life. See what he wants to do. Isaiah 43.
Verse
18. Remember ye not the former things. Neither consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing. Somebody there. I said somebody there. Almighty God says tonight, this night, I will do a new thing. And then it says, now it shall spring forth. When is your miracle? When is your healing? When is your salvation? When is your lifting up? It says, now it shall spring up. Shall ye not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness. And rivers in the desert. The Lord has said, your time has come. What will he do? What has he promised to do? So as to bring us to what Adam and Eve lost. Number one, a new heart. A new heart. The heart is the center of your life. The heart is the source of your thinking. The heart is the fountain of your strength. The heart is the starting point of your progress. If the heart is weak, your life will be weak. If your heart is downtrodden and trampled upon, your life is downtrodden and trampled upon. If your heart is timid and weak, your life will be timid and weak. If your heart is sinful, your life will be sorrowful and your life will be sinful. And he says, come to me today, I'll give you a new heart. Somebody there. A new heart is coming. I said, a new heart is coming. Ezekiel chapter 36. I'm reading from verse 25. Then when I speak, O clean water upon you, and you shall be clean. From all your filthiness and from all your idols will I cleanse you. A new heart, a new heart, a new heart will I also give you. And a new spirit will I put within you. I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh, and I will give you a heart of flesh. He says, a new heart. That's your portion. Lord, I receive. Lord, I receive. Oh, a new obedience is a secret of miracle. Jesus was in the marriage at the Cana of Galilee. And the wine had finished. Their joy was about to finish. Their excitement was finished. And the scene that made that occasion lively for them, everything was finished. You know, people, excitement has finished in their lives. Joy has finished in their lives. Excitement and life, being lively, hope has finished in their lives. They are dragging through life. I say, my friend, what's the problem? Says there is nothing within to keep me excited, happy, and joyful. Home, family, nothing good.
Ani ebi o ati gbogbo
duro. Profession, nothing good.
Ani oja mi ati se ti mo jan
lai o ti baje. Anywhere I go, everything is down.
Ibi gbogbo ti mo ba lo gbogbo e lo ti
dori kodo. Wine had finished.
Wine ti tan.
And Mary came to those servants.
Maria wa wa sodo awon iranse na.
And said, we need a miracle.
Wani anilo ise iyanu.
Somebody there tonight, you need a miracle.
Eni kan nibe yin o nilo ise iyanu.
Whatsoever he says unto you, do it. He didn't know what he was going to tell them. But obedience. A new obedience. Whatsoever he says unto you, do it. And Jesus said, fill all those water pots with water. But we need wine. Whatsoever he says unto you, do it. Stand up. But I cannot stand up. Whatsoever he says unto you, do it. Come unto me. All ye that labor and are heavy laden. And I will give you rest. But I've been going to church. But I've been baptized as an infant. Whatsoever he says unto you, do it. And then he brought the water. And he filled it up. All the pots. He said, draw it out now. Are you not going to touch it? Are you not going to pray? Are you not going to look to the Father? Don't argue. Whatsoever he says unto you, do it. And he took the water. And he took it to the master of ceremony. A miracle had happened. As we respond to the Lord tonight, Lord Jesus, I come. I will do what you ask me to do. I will go where you tell me to go. I will turn away from what you are telling me to turn from. As
you
come between that place and this place, a miracle will happen to you. A new life. I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live. You identify with
Christ.
It was for me he died. It was for me he was crucified. And I want to have this crucified life. A person that is crucified. Look at those people crucified on the cross with Christ. Those who are crucified on the cross, they don't fight anymore. They cannot be cruel anymore. They cannot be part of the gang anymore. And they cannot say, I marked that house, I'm going to that house in the night. They cannot see a prostitute passing by and say, I'm coming down. I'll come and see you. He's crucified. I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live. Yet the life which I now live, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. A new life. A new instrument. A new instrument. Where are you there? Are you still there? Look up. As I look up. If it rains, the rain will not cancel your miracle. You will not go and hide somewhere. Because God is about to distribute miracles. Your portion is coming. Your portion is coming. Where are you there? It will get to you. It, you will get to it.